Traditional sound, which is plateau, and that's a really beautiful effect. In a way, I think the danger with writing music not on paper and relying on computers and demos is that you start to get used to how some string sounds, and then just throw it down. Whereas the variety of colour that, you know, one player can make on a string instrument is quite mind blowing, and just the combination of a whole ensemble and all the directions it can go, it's really exciting and daunting. And it's easily my favourite day of the year is when the string players turn up for an afternoon.
Do you want the strings to be perfectly tuned, or do you want them to be just slightly off?
Yes. To have half the players tuned a quarter tone flat, so just a little bit out of tune, but all as out of tune as one another, if you see what I mean. But because they're playing with their ears, it's very hard to do, so they're still making their fingers go to where their ear wants to hear the right note. So even though it was difficult to do and sort of weren't doing it properly, it was one of those things where you just end up being even more impressed by what they can do and how they're playing and thinking and making these sounds.
One of your influences, who you've also worked with, is Krzysztof Penderecki, an avant-garde composer, who once said that we have to use instruments which were built 300 years ago or 200, and the newest instrument in the orchestra is the saxophone, but that's at least 100 years old. And he said, in the century of landing on the moon, he said this during the 20th century, we still have to write for very old instruments, museum instruments. I think this is the problem. It became the problem in the second half of the 20th century that there's not much progress because of the lack of instruments, of new instruments. And I thought of you when I read that. This is quoted on an album that you collaborated with him in on. I thought of you because it seems to me you want to make old instruments sound new by messing them up a little bit, by doing unusual things with them or having them do unusual things with each other. Whether it's their tunings or their dissonances, the number of instruments you use. So do you relate to that quote about using old instruments for new music?
I do, because I've always found acoustic instruments, certainly orchestral instruments, to be capable of much more variety and strangeness and complexity than, you know, nearly all the software I've used in the past. And I think that's maybe why, to me, music by people like Penderecki and Ligeti, and they just still sound very strange and contemporary, and they still sound like music of the future to me, whereas lots of the electronic stuff that was done in the 60s and 70s, you hear it now and it's sort of of its time.
Oh, that's so true. That is really true.
And I think that all instruments are just technology, however old or new they are, and the ideal situation is where you can just... whether it's a, you know, a piano or a laptop or an electric guitar or a tuba, they're all hugely exciting things, you know. And you know, I remember as a 10-year-old, whatever, whenever my mum was driving us around, if we went past a music shop, my daydream as we drove past was never imagine being able to go in and buy a guitar or whatever. It would be imagine being able to go and buy a flute or a trumpet. I was just fascinated with all these different colours and ways of making music and making sounds. And in a really tragic middle-aged man kind of way, that's sort of what I've turned my life into, as I'm sitting talking to you, surrounded by, you know, those kind of instruments.
But I'm wondering, getting back to that Penderecki quote, I'm wondering if you try to make old instruments sound just a little bit unrecognizable and use them in a way that sounds new, even though the instrument is old.